Local government, urban. The towns and cities are much bigger and more thickly populated and advanced than the villages. The problems of urban areas are in some respects common and in some other respects different from those of rural areas. There are three chief units of local government in cities and towns. They are Nagar Panchayat, Municipality and Municipal Corporation. While the big cities like Delhi, Mumbai, Kolkata and Chennai have municipal corporations, other small cities and towns have Nagar Panchayat and Municipal Council or Municipality. Nagar Panchayat. A Nagar Panchayat is set up for an area that is changing from a rural to an urban type. This is called a transitional area. Such an area does not qualify for the setup of a municipality but is considered important enough to have a local self-governing body. Main functions. It keeps records of births and deaths. It provides civic amenities such as safe drinking water, electricity, etc. It constructs roads and maintains them. It also opens parks, primary schools and dispensaries. Sources of income. Income from the taxes such as house tax, sales tax, vehicle tax, etc. Grants from the state government. Municipality. A municipality or a municipal committee or municipal council is a local self-governing body in small towns and cities. Population more than 20,000. Composition. About 15 to 60 members of a municipal committee are generally directly elected by registered voters. The city is divided into wards for the purpose of election. A voter must be a citizen of India, at least 18 years of age, and a resident of the city, while a candidate must also have these qualifications, plus his or her age should be 21 years. These elected members may elect a president, chairman, and a vice president, vice chairman. The president presides over the meeting of the municipal committees and carries out the functions with the help of the executive officer and other officers like the secretary, the health officer, the municipal engineer, etc. Reservation of seats. Seats are reserved in a corporation or municipality for the scheduled castes and scheduled tribes in the ratio of their population to the total population of the town or city. Not less than 1/3 of these members must be women from these castes and tribes. Problem of cities. The problems of the people living in cities are quite different from those of the people living in rural areas. The cities are thickly populated. They are spread over a vast area. The population and the areas of the cities are ever expanding. Metropolises like Delhi, Kolkata, Chennai, Mumbai, Ahmedabad, Kanpur, Lucknow, Patna, etc. have millions of people living over an area covering miles together. To provide transport, pure drinking water, regular electricity supply, schools and colleges, and other essential amenities is the duty of the local self-government there, which is called the municipal corporation. Functions of municipality and municipal corporations. The functions of a corporation or a municipality are generally similar. If there is any difference, it is only in the extent and scope than in their content. As the corporation has more funds and autonomy, it can expand the scope of its operations. It can expand the scope of its functions to cope with the needs of the people. But broadly speaking, these functions are more or less the same. We can divide the functions of the urban local self-government into two classes: essential or compulsory functions, optional or voluntary functions. Essential or compulsory functions. The municipalities and the municipal corporations have some essential or compulsory functions. Public health. The first main function is to establish hospitals and dispensaries. They also have to arrange vaccinations to protect people against diseases like smallpox, cholera and tuberculosis. It is also their duty to prevent adulteration of food. Proper care is taken for sanitation and cleanliness of the town, which includes cleaning of drains and streets, removal of rubbish and garbage, and maintenance of sewage system. It provides public urinals and other conveniences. It keeps a check on food adulteration, sale of intoxicants, and the growth of slums in and around the city. Public works and services. The local self-government in the urban areas provides good roads and streets in its areas and maintains them in good condition. Trees are planted on both sides of the roads for shade. Roadside urinals and toilets are provided. Water and electricity supply are made available in the city for residential houses, offices, factories, schools, colleges, etc. They also maintain graveyards, cremation grounds, or electric crematoriums to bury or cremate the dead. They also maintain the records of births and deaths. Public education. Education is a very important function of the local self-government. The local bodies establish and manage primary schools and even give grant in aid to other organizations for running the primary schools. These bodies are obliged to see that all children within the age group of 6 to 14 years go to school. They also open libraries, reading rooms, museums, zoological parks, mobile libraries, and adult education centers. Public safety. Another important function of a local body is to provide public safety against fire and dilapidated buildings. For this, it maintains fire engines and a trained staff to save life and property of the people against fire or against a building likely to fall and could be a danger to human life. It can pull down old and dangerous buildings which might cause a mishap. Similarly, cinema houses, theatres, marriage places, petrol pumps are also set up with due sanction of the local bodies and according to some specific requirements which these places must fulfill. The corporation and the municipality has to keep a check on these places to ensure public safety. Optional or voluntary functions. The following are the optional or voluntary functions of the local self-government which should be performed if funds permit. To provide toilets, bathrooms, bathing ghats, washing ghats, etc. Maintain rest houses, night shelters, children's homes, orphanages, senior citizens' homes, homes for destitute women. To run educational institutions like schools, colleges, polytechnics, etc. To develop parks, gardens, picnic spots, museums, zoos, or other places like swimming pools, playgrounds, etc. To provide cheap and efficient local bus service or any other mode of transport. Sources of income. The local self-government needs funds for carrying out their duties. Some of the sources of their funds are octroi duty on goods brought into the city, taxes on houses and land called property tax, income from water supply, taxes on business and professions. Certain municipalities tax facilities like public lighting and hygiene, tax on vehicles, parking places, markets and hawkers, toll tax for use of roads and bridges, grants from the state government, educational tax for educational activities, rent collected from buildings owned by the urban local body, loans with the approval of the state government, entertainment tax. Municipality. A municipality or a municipal committee or municipal council is a local self-governing body in small towns and cities. Population more than 20,000. Composition. About 15 to 60 members of a municipal committee are generally directly elected by registered voters. The city is divided into wards for the purpose of election. A voter must be a citizen of India, at least 18 years of age, and a resident of the city, while a candidate must also have these qualifications, plus his or her age should be 21 years. These elected members may elect a president, chairman, and a vice president, vice chairman. The president presides over the meeting of the municipal committees and carries out the functions with the help of the executive officer and other officers like the secretary, the health officer, the municipal engineer, etc. Reservation of seats. Seats are reserved in a corporation or municipality for the scheduled castes and scheduled tribes in the ratio of their population to the total population of the town or city. Not less than 1/3 of these members must be women from these castes and tribes. Problem of cities. The problems of the people living in cities are quite different from those of the people living in rural areas. The cities are thickly populated. They are spread over a vast area. The population and the areas of the cities are ever expanding. Metropolises like Delhi, Kolkata, Chennai, Mumbai, Ahmedabad, Kanpur, Lucknow, Patna, etc. have millions of people living over an area covering miles together. To provide transport, pure drinking water, regular electricity supply, schools and colleges, and other essential amenities is the duty of the local self-government there, which is called the municipal corporation. Functions of municipality and municipal corporations. The functions of a corporation or a municipality are generally similar. If there is any difference, it is only in the extent and scope than in their content. As the corporation has more funds and autonomy, it can expand the scope of its operations. It can expand the scope of its functions to cope with the needs of the people. But broadly speaking, these functions are more or less the same. We can divide the functions of the urban local self-government into two classes: essential or compulsory functions, optional or voluntary functions. Essential or compulsory functions. The municipalities and the municipal corporations have some essential or compulsory functions. Public health. The first main function is to establish hospitals and dispensaries. They also have to arrange vaccinations to protect people against diseases like smallpox, cholera, and tuberculosis. It is also their duty to prevent adulteration of food. Proper care is taken for sanitation and cleanliness of the town, which includes cleaning of drains and streets, removal of rubbish and garbage, and maintenance of sewage system. It provides public urinals and other conveniences. It keeps a check on food adulteration, sale of intoxicants, and the growth of slums in and around the city. Public works and services. The local self-government in the urban areas provides good roads and streets in its areas and maintains them in good condition. Trees are planted on both sides of the roads for shade. Roadside urinals and toilets are provided. Water and electricity supply are made available in the city for residential houses, offices, factories, schools, colleges, etc. They also maintain graveyards, cremation grounds, or electric crematoriums to bury or cremate the dead. They also maintain the records of births and deaths. Public education. Education is a very important function of the local self-government. The local bodies establish and manage primary schools and even give grant in aid to other organizations for running the primary schools. These bodies are obliged to see that all children within the age group of 6 to 14 years go to school. They also open libraries, reading rooms, museums, zoological parks, mobile libraries and adult education centers. Public safety. Another important function of a local body is to provide public safety against fire and dilapidated buildings. For this, it maintains fire engines and a trained staff to save life and property of the people against fire or against a building likely to fall and could be a danger to human life. It can pull down old and dangerous buildings which might cause a mishap. Similarly, cinema houses, theatres, marriage places, petrol pumps are also set up with due sanction of the local bodies and according to some specific requirements which these places must fulfill. The corporation and the municipality has to keep a check on these places to ensure public safety. Optional or voluntary functions. The following are the optional or voluntary functions of the local self-government which should be performed if funds permit. To provide toilets, bathrooms, bathing ghats, washing ghats, etc. Maintain rest houses, night shelters, children's homes, orphanages, senior citizens' homes, homes for destitute women. To run educational institutions like schools, colleges, polytechnics, etc. To develop parks, gardens, picnic spots, museums, zoos, or other places like swimming pools, playgrounds, etc. To provide cheap and efficient local bus service or any other mode of transport. Sources of income. The local self-government needs funds for carrying out their duties. Some of the sources of their funds are octroi duty on goods brought into the city, taxes on houses and land called property tax, income from water supply, taxes on business and professions. Certain municipalities tax facilities like public lighting and hygiene, tax on vehicles, parking places, markets and hawkers, toll tax for use of roads and bridges, grants from the state government, educational tax for educational activities, rent collected from buildings owned by the urban local body, loans with the approval of the state government, entertainment tax. Relationship of the local bodies with state government. The local bodies work under the overall control of the state government. There is a minister for local self-government in most of the states. He keeps a control of the local bodies in the state. In fact, the local body, a corporation or a municipality, are created by a law of the state government. The state government keeps a check on its finances and gets their accounts audited regularly. The permission of the state government is necessary to levy a new tax or to raise a loan. If the work of the municipality or a corporation is found unsatisfactory, the state government can dissolve it. Actually, local self-government is a state subject under the Constitution of India.